the octet on the cave. Guhataka Sutta. Struck in the cave, densely covered over, dwelling immersed in bewilderment, a person such as this is far from seclusion. For in the world, sensual pleasures are not easily abandoned. Based upon desire, bound to enjoyment of existence, they let go with difficulty, for there is no release through others. Concerned, too, with the future or the past, they hanker for these sensual pleasures or earlier ones. Those greedy for sensual pleasures, intent on them, are confused, stingy, settled in unrighteous. When they come upon suffering, they lament, "What will we be after we pass away here?" Therefore, a person should train right here. Whatever in the world one might know as unrighteous, one should not, on its account, act unrighteously, for the wise says, "This life is short." I see in the world this population trembling all over, addicted to craving for states of existence. Inferior people prattle in the mouth of death, not devoid of craving for various states of existence. See them trembling over things taken as mine, like fish in a depleted stream with little water. Having seen this too, one should take nothing as mine, not forming attachment to states of existence. Having removed desire for both ends, having fully understood contact without greed, not doing anything for which one might blame oneself, the wise person is not tainted by things seen or heard. Having fully understood perception, one can cross the flood, the Muni, untainted by possessions. With the dart extracted, living heedfully, does not desire this world or another.